So very good evening, guys. This is Piyush Khandelwal, and I welcome you all to your own channel, which is Geeks for Geeks Practice, right? So guys, we are back with again a pair programming session, right? We are getting a lot of love from your side. We were getting feedbacks that you are loving the sessions. And why we have started this session, let me brief you about it, that we started this session so that you can learn how to part, like how teams participate in hackathons, how the team participate in these programming contests like ICPC. So you get a mock feeling of that, right? How actually you work together, because it's easy to think individually, right? But participating in a team, working in a team requires that that spirit, which is mandatory, right? To win the competitions. So I would not be wasting your time. I would be revealing the guest of the day, because you might have already know about them, that they are Pavan and Anil with us, who are going to participate in today's contest. And I hope you will love the problems. But let me summarize you how this event is going to be, that I will invite Pavan and Anil over here, right? After that, we will have a brief discussion, and they will start the contest. They will start solving the problems. They will actually solve the contest. Will have three problems, right? And they will submit those problems. And after that, we will be discussing about the solutions, the approaches they followed, like why they thought of the solution. And you can also ask your questions, like how they were able to figure out the strategies, right, to solve those problems. So stay there with us. See the problems. What are the problems of the contest? Try to solve on your own. And if you miss them, if you are not able to figure out the correct solution for the problem, right, then wait for their discussion, right? Wait for their feedbacks on the problems and the solutions. So let me not waste your time and theirs. Let me call Pavan. Hey, Pavan, how's you?
Hello, Piyush. I'm fine. How are you?
And here is Anil, right? Hello, Anil.
Hello, Piyush.
Excited?
Yeah, sure. Ready for the contest.
You people are already excited. Like, you have a very great team. Like, you both have built up a very good team. And our audience also loving your combination, right? I can say Pavan and Anil are like nailing the these sessions, right? These pair Thank programming you. Sessions. So let's not waste our time. Pavan, I'm sharing your screen here. Right, so this is the session today. So Pavan, can we start with the contest, and we can reveal the problems of these sessions, today's session?
Okay, yeah. So like as Piyush explained earlier, that this is our fourth session on the pair programming, and I'm going to register for the contest just now. And there will be three problems, and we will be having 1 hour to solve all three problems. So now let us move on to the problem and see how it goes. So here are the
okay. So meanwhile, I am transferring the control to Pavan and Anil, so you people can continue, right? And Pavan, Anil, we will be answering the queries of people, of our audience, at the last of the session, right?
Okay, right.
Sure.
Okay. So all the best for both of you.
Yes. Right. So I think anyone from the audience can confirm, like, if we are perfectly audible and our screen is visible or not. It will be great if someone can acknowledge. Meanwhile, let me open the first problem.
Let's start from the first problem itself.
Okay, thank you, Lucifer. Okay, so this is the first problem. Let me read out the problem first for you. So in this problem, we are given two numbers, A and B. The task is to compute the last digit of the resulting F, where F is equal to B factorial divided by A factorial. Okay, I think it is like a very small statement. So let me explain the problem.
What are the constraints?
Okay, constraint is A and B are quite large. They are like 10 to the power 18. And there are test cases also. Okay, so in this problem,
So that's the basically problem statement.
Okay, so we have to calculate the last digit of their division, right? So let's take example. For example, let's say A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 3, right?
Yeah.
Then A factorial divided by B factorial will be equal to...
We have to find B factorial by A factorial actually.
Okay, look, so that's like, let me write it that way so that there will be no confusion. So here, let's say A is equal to 5 and B is equal to 7. Now, since F is equal to B factorial divided by A factorial, so we can write it as 7 into 6 and into 5 factorial
divided. 5 factorial.
So it will come out to be 7 into 6, which is equal to 6, 7, 0, 42.
42, so last digit is 2.
So last digit is, therefore answer is 2. So this is the problem. So let us...
So we can basically write B factorial, since B is always greater than equal to 6. A, so we can always write B as like this, something like this.
Right. Factorial. Yeah, it is given in the question, right? That B is always greater than equal to. Yeah, B is always greater than equal to.
In the constraint.
Right. So if B is always greater than equal to C, then we can say that B, like A always divides B, right? That is pretty straightforward. Yeah, B is a multiple of A for sure.
And B factorial is multiple of A factorial, so.
Yeah, B factorial is, sorry. Just a second, I think. So,
we have to find the last digit of this expression, product from A plus 1 to B.
Right. Yeah. So we just the example which we took right now, like we will be having B is equal to 7 and like A is equal to 5. So in this, we just like, if we divide B factorial by A factorial, then the answer will always be equal to like the product of these value, A plus 1 into A plus 2 into like that up to B, right?
Yeah. So I guess we can say that if this range is greater than a certain amount, then the answer will always be 0.
Right. Yeah, so this is the observation in this question mainly. Because if we have like 5 and 2 as the factor, right,
and answer will always be 5
into 2 will come out to be 10, and if for any number which is divisible by 10, then they must have 0 as their last digit, right?
Yeah,
like, and this is always true for any number n. If n mod 10 is equal to 0, then last digit of
n is
always equal to 0.
That's basically the divisibility rule of 10.
Yeah, basically divisibility rule of 10 is that last digit will be 0. Okay, so I think, this is...
The range, if the length of range is greater than 10, then obviously like we will have a factor of 10 in the range. So I think we can say that if the difference between B and A is greater than or equal to 10, the answer will always be 0.
Are you sure? Greater than 10, is it necessary for it to be greater than 10? I think like from 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. Like any five consecutive numbers, we will always be having one factor of like one multiple of five and one multiple of two, I think.
Oh, okay. We can prime factorize 10 and compress the range a bit. Like it will be if a minus b is greater than or equal to 5, then also it will be resolved by.
This is the proof, and like if for any like it is true for all consecutive five numbers, right? If we have any five consecutive number, then we will always have at least one number which is multiple of five, and at least one number which is multiple of two, right?
Yeah.
This is always the case. So,
if the gap between A and B is greater than or equal to five, then last digit will be always zero, I guess.
Right. So what we can say that. So this is the first condition. If B minus A is greater than or equal to 5, then answer will be always 0 because of the previous discussion. For any consecutive 5 numbers, there like we will always have 2 and 5, and product of 2 into 5 is always 10. So for any number which is divisible by 10, their last digit will be 0, right? And what about the other case? If the difference is less than 5, then we can do the brute force, right? We can just traverse.
Just write a brute force solution, yes.
Yeah, because it will be constant then. Like we just have to traverse at most 5.
At most 5 numbers. Yeah.
Yeah. So we just have to, in that case, we just have to calculate a plus 1 into a plus 2 into in worst case this a plus 5, right? So there will be at most 5 iterations only. So, but I think there is one more problem. We have A and B around 1E18, right?
Yeah.
So we cannot multiply the number of such large number because they will be given.
Since you are concerned about the last digit only, so we will store the last digit only in our current product. We can store current result. And we will store the last digit only in our result. So we can calculate all the stuff in int only.
Yeah, right. So this is also true, I think. Last digit of A into B will
be affected by the last digit of A and B only.
So it will be equal to last digit of the product of last digit of A. Yeah. So we don't need to multiply the whole numbers, right? We just have to multiply the last digits. Yeah. So I think pretty much the logic is clear. I think mere ko to samajh mein aa gaya. I can implement this now. Yeah. So dekhte rehna agar koi typo na karu.
Yeah, sure.
I think Anil, मैं कोड कर रहा हूँ तब तक तू ये डाउट ले ले ये लूसीफर कह रहा है कि b factorial upon a factorial का वो क्या हो रहा है
b factorial by a factorial should have 2 and a 5 लूसीफर को यार देखो we have b factorial by a factorial so we are claiming that if the difference is greater than or equal to 5 then b factorial by a factorial का last digit will always be 0 and let's say you have a numbers from k to let's say a to b range mein you have some numbers so you can see that if you are checking divisibility by a number k then har k mein se ek number will be divisible by k and why is that let's say for example we take 2 then agar hum 1 chode then 2 is divisible by okay nice we got it
okay nice so I was just giving this example from 1 to 5 we are having 2 into 5. Now let's write 5 consecutive numbers starting from 2. Here also we will be having 5 and 2. Now let us write 5 consecutive number from 3 to like starting from 3. So here we are having 5 and here we are having like 4 can be written as 2 into 2.
Or right?
6. And there in 6 also. So likewise, if I start from 4, here I am having 5 and again 4. And if like the case will be if I let's say I am starting from 6.
You took 6 numbers in last example.
So in this case also we can see that here 10 itself is present, or moreover here is 5 and we can have 2 from any, like 2 is present in 8 and 10 and 6 also. So we can see that we can always find at least 1 5 and 1 2. So this is the logic.
Yeah.
So what is the input?
It should be long by the way. Long
yeah, we have to pay. Yeah, sorry. So I'm just right. Now you are in chat, Lucifer, write the correct condition. If b minus a is greater than or equal to 5 is also fine.
Yeah, I guess equal to 5 is fine. Hello, Pawan.
Yes.
I can just. You are having some network issues.
Very. Okay.
So pretty much the code we discussed, while b is greater than a, we will find the product of b and store the result in a variable and take the mod with 10.
Anil, am I audible now?
Yeah, you are audible now.
Okay. So I can update last as last into the last digit of b, which will be b modulus 10. And I can just do this thing, right?
So the last is
yeah. And I will decrement. Okay. So it will not give me like integer and overflow anywhere, right? No. Oh. Integer last is okay, right?
Because last is 1 and b mod 10, 10 is what I am. So
last
will never be 10.
Okay, I am taking mod at every. I am taking, because I am taking mod at every point, therefore it will not exceed 100 at any point, right? So I just have to. So I think this is fine, right?
Yeah,
I'm not missing anything. Let's compare. It works on sample. So let me submit it. It is, I think, fairly easy question. Okay. So we are having correct. You see.
Okay, you can move to the next question now.
Let's move on to the next question. The name of the question is maximum profit. So let me read out the question first. So in the stock market, a person buys a stock and sells it on some future date. Given a stock prices of n days in an array A and a positive integer k, find out the maximum profit a person can make in at most k transactions. Okay, a transaction is equivalent to buying plus selling of a stock, and new transaction can start only when the previous transaction has been completed. Okay. So at a moment we can just make like we cannot buy multiple stocks and like hold them, and
So
we cannot do that.
You can just buy one stock, hold it and sell it, and then only buy another one.
Okay. So let me explain the question. So in this question, let us see the constraint first. So n is 500 and k is right. So this is the example. These are the test cases. and
K n and array of n.
This is the value of k, which means that we can make at most 2 transactions, and 6 is the size of array. So these are like in this array, these are the prices. Like we know that the stock market is like very volatile. Each day the prices goes up and down. So we have to be very precise to make profit there. So these are the prices of a certain stock at each day. So what I can do is I can make at most k transaction. What I mean by transaction is I can buy some stock and I will sell them. So these both operation, buying and sell, will combinedly make one operation, right?
Yeah.
So I can make at most k operations like these. Okay. So
let's say we will buy a stock on, like, when its price is 10, and we can sell the stock when its price is 22. So our profit will be 12.
Okay, so let us write it here and explain it. Let's take this example and let's discuss about the solution. How can we get the optimal answer, right? So it is 10, 22, 5. 10, 22, 5, 75, 65, 80. 75, 65, 80. And value of k is equal to 2, which means that I can make at most k transactions. Right. So first of all, let us move just like that. I will buy one stock at here, and I'm selling it here. So I can see that there is a profit. So because I am selling it at 22 and I was
buying it here.
Let us mark as B1 and S1. So I'm selling it for 22 and buying it for 10. Therefore, this will be my profit. And let's say another day I am just, I'm not doing anything here. I was lazy. I missed that day because, so I just bought another stock at 75 price, and I see here that it is lower. Let's assume I sell it on that day, right? So what will be the contribution? So
it will be 80 minus 75.
Yeah, 80 minus 75. So if I do my transaction this way, then the total profit will come out to be 12 plus 5, which will be 17. So as we all can see that it is not the optimal way, right? So instead of that, what I can do is I am not doing my transaction here. I can buy my stock at the price 5 and sell it at 80. So instead of that, in that case, my profit will come out to be 80 minus 5. So in that case, the answer will be 12 plus
75.
So it will be 87. So I can see that this is better. So that, I have to decide on which days I will buy the stock and on which day I have to sell the stock. So this is the question. And one more thing, what I mean by as written in the question, we can make at most one transaction at a time. By that, we mean that if we buy this stock here, so we cannot buy another stock here because we are holding just one stock already. So first we have to sell this stock, and when we sell this stock, then only we can buy another stock, right? Because if this is not the case, then what we can do is we can just buy one stock here, buy one stock here, and we will find the maximum, the highest price, and we will sell all these stock at this. So this is not the question. Therefore, it is specified in the question that we can just make one transaction at a time. So yeah, so this is the question.
And we have to do at most k transactions,
We have to do at most k. We can make one, two. I think this example, say 105. So in this example, we cannot, if we make any transaction, we will be having loss only, right?
Yeah.
So minus in this 95. Case, it is optimal not to make any, not to make any transaction. So yeah.
So the answer will be always at least greater than equal to zero. And
yeah, yeah. We will not be in loss at any moment. So looking at the constraints, I think we can do something like n into k type solution, right?
Or because it is even do n square into k type solution. That is work.
10 to the power of 4. Yeah, we can also do n square into k, but that makes no sense in, I think, n square into k. Yeah, I think
n into k is, of course, we can think something in terms of n into k. But we can obviously think a 2 to the power n into k solution like.
Yeah, so first of all, let's try to write one recursive solution of it. Like, right, we can do recursive solution for any problem, I think.
Okay.
If we don't look at the constraints, we can just try to form, because I think there is no greedy way of doing this, right?
Yeah, we will have to use DP.
Because why greedy will not work? Because in greedy, what we can do is we can just try to buy at the lower prices, and we will try to sell them at the higher prices. But in case, let us take one example.
Now we can solve this problem by greedy for k equal to 1, I guess. Find the least buying price for each possible transaction.
Yeah, so basically let's discuss if I am I'm seeing that this is the lowest, right? And after that, let me write 3 here. So if when I see this 3, so I and here is 4, so 4 is less than 3, then I see, I can think that there is a dip here, so I will try to sell it at 4. I'm not this is not working, of course. If I sell this at 4, then I will be having profit of just 2. Instead of that, I can sell it as hold it further and sell it at 10, so that I can have the profit.
But if you can do transactions, then of course you should sell it at 4, because you can earn more profit if you have 2 transactions.
Right. I missed it. For greedy approach, what I can think is I will bought it for 2, and I will try to find the maximum rate for it for selling. So for that, I will just keep on searching, and I will see that the maximum profit maximum rate is 10. So I will sell it for 10 minus 2, 8. And if my value of k is 2. But here the optimal part is I will just buy one here, sell one here, and buy another one here and sell one here. So in this case, the total profit will come out to be, which is equal to 2 plus 7, which is greater than 8, of course. Right. So greedy is not working here. So we,
of course, we'll have to write an n into k DP.
We have to think in dynamic programming. So let us, first of all, let us try to write the brute force solution in, right?
Yeah.
So what I can do is let this be a function. And let me explain it this way. For each day, I am writing in terms of each day. For any day, what are the options which I am having, right? Let's work on these.
You can buy a stock or you can sell a stock.
Yeah, I have two options, three options, right? I can buy a stock, I can sell a stock, and I can do nothing. I can rest that day. I am lazy, right? So yeah, these are the options. So let us list all of the options. So, but but we cannot buy any stock. Like, there is also one condition for buying also, because if we want to buy a stock, then there should not be any active transaction going on.
So we can maintain boolean variable can buy or something, like, which will denote if we can buy a stock or not.
Yeah, so let me first of all list all this in a diagrammatically way so that it is more clear. So for each day, what are the options I am having? First of all, the option is whether I have to check that I have to see that whether I bought a stock before or not bought, not have any stock, right? So first option is
each of them.
Yeah. So first of all, I can categorize my each day by these two categories, whether I am holding a stock or I am not holding a stock, right?
Yeah.
So after I categorize this, then I have two options. If I am if I bought one stock before, then what option I have is I can sell it.
Or you can do nothing.
Yeah. And another option is do nothing. Right. And here, if I haven't bought any stock yet, so what I can do is I can buy a stock. Right. Another option is, do nothing option is always there, right?
Okay.
So I think these are all the options which I have on each day.
So we'll have to maintain a variable to check whether we have already bought a stock or not. And if you are writing a recursive solution, you will need a variable which points to the current day.
Yeah. So what I can conclude from here is I will be requiring, I have to store if I if I bought a stock or not, right?
Yeah.
I have to keep track of that. If I am currently on IS day, I am holding a stock or not. I have to keep track of this. And I think we just have to keep track of that. And if I know that I am holding a stock, then I have these two options. And if I am not holding a stock, then I have these two options. So likewise, I can proceed, right?
Yeah, and you will also need I to find the day on which you are currently.
That to find, and I have just okay. So let us try to write the recursive solution for that. Right. So let's move to coding part. First of all, in DB solutions, I just prefer to write the brute force recursive solution so that the things are more clear. And after that, we will try to optimize it. So in that way, the things are more clear. We will take the input later. We are just in building phase. We are just building the solution. So what we required, this is the current day, right? Current day.
The boolean variable which denotes we have already bought a stock or not. And we will also need one more variable. Remaining transactions to check whether
remaining
we have already done transactions or not.
We can make at most k transactions. So we have to see this one more variable to keep track how many transactions we have made so far. And here we can have one variable hold, which means that am I holding one stock or not. So coming to this part here, I will check if I am holding or not, right? So if hold is equal to one, which means that I am holding, like I have bought one stock previously. So what I can do is
I can
move to the next day. And let's consider case. Consider the case I am like selling it, right? So if I am selling it, then what will be the value which
you will get array of current day price from it?
Yeah. So it will be the cost of current day, because if I sell a stock, then the price of that stock on current day will be added to my answer, right? So I will add that to my answer and call it for the next day. And I have completed one transaction, so I will like decrement my And as I sold my like the stock, therefore the value of hold will be equal to zero, right? So I will store. I can store this thing in answer. This is the one possibility, right? We have two choices here, as we can see in that diagram. Yeah. So far we have done this thing. We sell it. What about we do nothing? So in that case, if we do nothing, then we can just doing nothing. We are just moving to the.
Move to next year, we have same number of transactions and the value of hold remains the same.
Yeah, everything remains the same. We are just moving to the next day because it is already happening. We are doing nothing. So everything else will remain same, right? And since we have to maximize our answer, so what we can do is we can take
max.
The max of these both of these conditions, right?
You have a bracket missing here. Find out.
Fine. Yeah. So this is the first thing. So I have covered this part. Now come to this thing. Like, what about the case if I haven't bought anything yet? So in that case, what I can do is I can buy a thing, like buy a stock. So for buying, I have to spend some money, right? So for that, I can spend the money of stock at like. What is the cost at that day? So I am using this minus sign so that I am spending it, so it will be subtracted from my answer. And I bought that one and I am moving to the next day, so I can write current day plus one. And here the transaction is not yet so we will not decrement because transaction is completed when we buy and sell it. So hence here the transaction is not.
We will only need to update the remaining transactions when we are like selling a stock finally.
Yeah, selling a stock, because a transaction is complete when we buy and sell it. So as soon as we sell it, we decrement the number of transactions. And another thing is like, as always, do nothing. So we are doing nothing and everything remains the same. Right. So these are the I think we have considered all the possibilities we listed here, right? So we buy the stock, we do nothing. So we have discussed this part also. We have discussed this part also. So at the end, what I can do is I can just return my answer. So I think brute force solution is pretty much clear and logic is also pretty much clear.
So yeah, but this will go into infinite loop. You should add some like base cases.
Oh, right. So what can be the base cases here?
If k equal to 0, we don't have to do anything. We can return 0.
Yeah, if all the transactions are happened, that means if remaining transactions are equal to 0, then I can return. I can say that no more transactions are possible. I can return from there. Or if like we are having this n days, right? So if we reach like all the days are over, then we can also say that whole transaction is over. So for that, I have to transfer here the variable n and this cost array also.
That's all, I guess. And you will have to like change add n and cost array to all the calls.
So we have to add it here also. So let's take the input first and proceed to the solution.
Yeah.
I think test cases ke constraint nahi likhe hue. That is the answer.
Oh, yes. You can't do n square input to our server.
So we take input.
Faster.
Let's take it as n only. We can just see out our this function. So we will starting from 0 to day. Current day is 0, really k. Initially not holding anything, therefore 0.
And then
cost array. So I think we can try to run this code.
Cout/n.
Okay. So we can try to compile this code and see if we write our brute force solution correct or not.
Yeah, I can do that.
Okay.
Cost of I.
Yeah. So as you can see that here answer 87, 1040, and 0. Yeah, so we can see that multiple cases are running. So that means that our logic is pretty much clear. But I cannot submit this problem, right? Because
this will give KD.
So what will be the time complexity of this? You want to discuss 30 minutes? I think we have enough time.
E to the power n into k.
So let's say. Here from watching this thing only we can conclude that at each day we are having two options, right? So for two options and there are n days. So for first day we are having two options, for second day we are having two options, for third day we are having two options. Likewise for nth day we are having two options, right? So the total number of options will be is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. Like n times. So the time complexity for
it's p to the power n only.
Yeah, for this recursive brute force solution will come out to be 2^n. So we cannot submit it. It will surely give us TLE. So now what we can do is we can just try to memoize it, right?
Yeah, we can store the answers.
Yeah, because we are calculating here same thing multiple times, as we call them overlapping sub problems. So we are having optimal substructure here, but we are having overlapping sub problems, right? So for avoiding them, we can here from these are called the states of the DP. So from here only we can say that what can be the maximum total number of states. How many states can be there? So
n and array are constant. We are not changing them. So
So we are given that current day can be equal to at most 500, right?
Yeah.
Let me write it here. So since current day can be maximum. Goes to 500 and remaining transaction can also go to up to 200 because in constraint we can see that n value of n is at most 500 and value of k is at most 200 and the value of this hold is 0 or 1. So there are only two choices, two options. So the total number of states which can be there are equal to 500 into 200 into 2, right? Which is equal to 2e5.
Only five, correct.
So these are the total number of states which we can have, and all the other, like all the other.
This will not give MLE, I was saying, like memory limit exceeded me. Yeah, we can show this.
Memory limit exceeded me. Yeah. So because these are the total, like total number of states. So जो 2 की power n आ रहा था वो इसलिए आ रहा था क्योंकि we are calculating the same problem again and again, like overlapping sub problems. Actually there are only these number of meaningful states, this like total number of states are there. So we just have to calculate these states. All the other states we do not have to calculate them again and again. So what we can do is we can just store the answer for them. So for doing that we can just have this is the whole point of DP. Like Anil will take the whole course on DP soon. So this is just a glimpse of that. We can have that idea. So this is the point of DP, memoization. So I can just declare this thing. Yeah, these are the, as we discussed, these are the maximum values of all the variables. And what I can do is initialize them.
DP to minus one.
If the value of like DP is minus one, then we can say that we haven't calculated that state yet. So we have to calculate that state, right? So we are initializing it to minus one, and we are just checking. Like we came to the we come to this state and we are checking if we like it works like the visited array in the graph, right? So we are just checking
value of minus one. Basically a value of minus one will denote that we have not been to that state yet, and you can use any number in place of minus one, but that number should not be a part of your answer. Like that should be an unreachable number from
answer. Because here we can see that our answer is always greater than or equal to zero, right? So minus one can never occur from like never be our answer. So we are taking it as minus one, right? So we are just treating it as a visited array. So we are checking that if this state has visited like in past or not. So if it is not equal to minus one, then we can say that we have visited this state previously. So what we can do is we can just return the answer of that state from here only. We don't have to move further. Like we do not have to calculate that state again. So it will save us so many transactions. Like from the time complexity of will drop from 2^n to just So we are just returning from here. This is the case. And here we are just marking that state at the end when we have calculated the answer of that state. What we can do it?
Well, we will store the optimal answer for that state.
Yeah, we are just storing the answer for that state, right? And we are just returning. So this is the difference between. Yeah, I have to equate. So this is the difference between like a 2^n brute force solution and an elegant like dynamic programming solution. Just these two, three lines, memoization. This is called memoization. So I guess the answer is still correct. So I think now we can submit it. We have to do it fast because time is running out. Let's hope it is correct. So this is right. So now quickly, let's go to the next problem. Okay, short. Let me read the problem for you. Given a sequence of non-negative integers, find the subsequence of length 3 having the maximum product with the element of subsequence being in increasing order.
What are the constraints?
Constraints are, if we do not find any increasing subsequence, then we have to return minus one.
Okay.
The constraints are quite large. We have t test case, 100 test cases, and value of n is 10 to the power 5. Okay. So let me try to assess this problem. So what are the sample test case? So let us discuss sample test case only. 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3. We are having 6,
7, 8,
9, 10.
9, 10.
Okay. So here, let's see the possibilities. What are we having? So we can take this, we can take this thing, because it is increasing and the product of these three will be like something 42 into 8. Kitna banta hai calculate kuch to aayega
42 into 8 is 16 4 is 32 336
aayega iska. So this is a possible candidate. Now we can check that if we can have, like in this case, we can clearly see that we have to choose 8, 9 and 10, right? Yeah, because these are the greatest three values and they form a subsequence. Subsequence is basically the order of them should not be changed as they are appearing in the array. And they are the largest value and they are in increasing order also.
Strictly increasing.
720. So this is the answer in this case. So basically, I think the brute force solution is quite simple. We can just have three nested loops.
But that will be too much. N is only 5. You have to do something like N or N log N.
Yeah, so N cube solution cannot be working because it will be too large. So, because we don't have to like explain N cube solution, we cannot think of it, right?
There is no obviously. Way.
So now, what can we do here? Like we. So, can we have? Like say currently I am at this index. So what I want to see, I want to choose like, this can be the good way to explain it. So if I am like currently at, I am currently at index 5. So let us say I am including this 5, like I am taking this 5 as my answer. So the one number should be from this part and the another number should be from this part, right?
So, and the number we are taking from the right should be the greatest number.
Yeah, from this part we have to like we want to choose, like we are just building, so this we can think that greedy way, we have to choose the greatest number from this range.
From the left we will choose the greatest number which is less than our current number.
Yeah, because in this range we cannot choose the greatest number, because if let me take one good example so that things are clear. So what can be the, yeah, so let us say this is our array and now currently I am at index 4, right? Now I am having my these two ranges because I have to choose three numbers, right? So I am just fixing my one number and try to choose other two numbers as optimally as I can.
Yeah, we'll fix right. The middle number and find the left and right number as like optimal as possible.
Yeah, so here from this range we can choose the greatest, right? It is 12. And in this range, if we try to choose the greatest, then it will come out to be 5. Then in that case, our like subsequence will be 5, 4, and 12, which is not increasing. So in question it is like we have to choose the increasing subsequence. So this sequence is not increasing. So right. So from this part, from left part, we cannot like blindly take the largest element.
So we have to take the largest like element. A stack or something like previous smallest element, which is.
We have to find. So let's make the conclusion right from the right side. While at this part, it is okay to choose the greatest element, right? Because there is no problem in choosing the greatest element because the third element should be the largest. So from the right part, we can take the largest element. And we have to check also like the largest element in this range should be greater than
this element.
Yeah,
that's of course, you can check that easily.
So I think right wala part is okay. It can be done easily. What about the left?
We can do the left wala part in n log n using set, obviously, but will that fit in time limit?
I think time limit can work. Time limit kitna
p is 100, n is 25
ka log kitna aata hai?
Around 17, I guess.
17 and or some n ka sum kitna hoga? 25 into 100 na
100
sare is mila ke to 17 ho jayega.
Around 28
ya around 28 operations lagenge. So I think time limit 2 second ki hogi to chal jayega na, agar 1 second टाइट रहेगा, अगर दो सेकंड रहती है शायद. आई थिंक
कैन वी इंप्लीमेंट दिस यूजिंग लाइक समथिंग लाइक स्टैक इन द ओपन.
आई डोंट, मेरे को नहीं लग रहा यार, क्योंकि स्टैक में वी जनरली नियरेस्ट लाइक फ्रॉम इंडेक्स लाइक वी कैन स्टोर द नियरेस्ट मैक्सिमम और नियरेस्ट मिनिमम थिंग बाय यूजिंग स्टैक.
सो वी कैन
नेक्स्ट
मिनिमम
Yeah, so I cannot think of a way to implement it using stack. We can try it using
how much time
that
is it
only set.
If we don't have much time, we can try the set solution.
There are 20 minutes. I think I can implement it in within 10-15 minutes. Let's discuss for 5 minutes more. So I think the right wala part is okay. We can just have like suffix max type array.
Yeah, right wala part is just using an array.
We can take the
left wala part can be easily done in n log n using a set or a multi-set. We can use a set for a multi-set.
Yeah, for left wala part we can store it into a set, and we can just like take a like we inside all the elements are sorted, so we can easily find the number which is like greatest number, which is
therefore.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. So you can easily do that using lower bound.
So let me like make things more clear. So suppose that I am currently at this index, and I will be having this right array, right? And
the left
array. So what my aim is to, isse kya mera aim hai, find the greatest element, right? Left right wale ka mere ko greatest element find karna hai, iska mere ko kya find karna hai? Greatest
element, greatest element which is also smaller than ai.
Yeah,
smaller than ai,
less than ai. So these are our aim. So how can we do that? We can do that this using suffix max
array. Suffix max array.
And we are doing this using set. Set or binary search is the same thing. So
not binary search, find lower bounding set, like
yeah, lower bound, lower bound. So I can write here is. Yeah, Venkat Sri Harsh is like almost there. The solution he suggested is fine. We just try to do it more efficiently. I think I should try to implement it and see if there is time limit exceeded, then we can try to think more, right? And I think if the time limits are like, as we know that in 1 second, 1E8 operations are okay. 1E8 operations can be performed, like, right? But here we are making like 1.7 E8 operations. So if time limit is 2 seconds, then our solution will work. And in general, I think 2 seconds is the time limit.
Even if it 1 second, like, we can try that.
Yeah, if it is even 1 second, sometimes 2E8 passes in 1 second also. It depends on the server speed. So. There are test cases. Here is the array. So what I need is I need one suffix max array. This is a pretty standard way to calculate the suffix max. I will not waste time in doing it because there is limited time. Right. So
it's correct.
I've calculated the suffix max thing. Now for prefix I can have a set. I do not need multi-set because I am just interested in that one value. I'm not interested in the multiple values of that. So I can just have one variable name answer. So if I didn't find any answer, then that's why I'm initializing it to minus one, because I have to print minus one if I don't get any answer.
So now we can just iterate.
So I think middle element, I can insert a zeroth element, right? Because I will start traversing from first element, because it can be for middle element, we need one element which is at left side and the element which are at right side, right? Therefore, we are just putting the first element.
You can iterate from 1 to n minus 2 only.
N minus, 0 to n, 1 to n minus 2 only. So I am just writing I less than n minus 1. Because at least one element should be there, at the right developer. Therefore.
Yeah. And now we will assume that we are taking A of I into answer. A of I are middle element. And we can find the right element from suffix max.
Okay.
And we can find the left element from our set.
Yeah, so in suffix max, the suffix max, in the suffix max array, like ith element is storing the max from I to n, right?
I plus 1 to n, I guess, from I to n.
Any?
I to n.
Suffix of I will store max from I to, I to the last element.
So
yeah,
you should use suffix of I plus 1.
So I can just name these variable a1, a2, a3. So this will be the third element. So I am just naming it a3. It will be equal to suffix of I plus 1. Our second element is upon a of I, just for finding that thing.
Suffix max of y, right?
Suffix max, okay, right. I just have to find the lower bound of my.
lower bound minus minus like iterator.
I will minus it. हाँ अगर वो begin रहा ना तो segmentation के लिए.
Yeah yeah. If iterator not equal to subtract begin. Then a two a1 equal to value at minus minus iterator.
Yeah, a1 is equal to star of minus minus i. Yeah.
And so you should check. You should also check like if a3 is greater than a2 or not.
Yeah. So now let us list all the conditions which are there, right? Which we have to check. So for a1, a2, and a3, for these three to be our answer, what are the necessary conditions? So the necessary conditions are a1 should be less than a2. Less than a3, right? So
yeah.
These are the necessary condition which we have to check here on also. So if a1 is less than a2 and a2 is less than a3, right? So if these conditions satisfy,
I think a1 less than a2, you don't need to check it.
Oh, we have to store the answer also, right?
You can take like current product. You don't need to check a1 less than a2. वो हो गई अगर हम lower bound से calculate कर रहे हैं तो.
Yeah, yeah, but still देख लेते हैं.
Okay.
So I can have one vector current answer in which I will store. So what I can do is if
a1
into three is less than answer or greater than answer, sorry,
greater than answer.
Yeah, yeah. In that case I will update my answer and I will update my
operator vector.
Yeah, current answer vector, right?
That's
so
I guess
at the end we will just print our, like, first of all let us check if answer is not equal to minus one, then we will just print our answer.
Else we can print minus one. Oh, you should print backslash n.
I am printing it here only, na.
Okay.
ऊपर वाले के लिए भी. So let us try to compile it. 69698. Okay, so it is always taking the first element. Oh, you see, पता चल रही है क्या problem है? Anyone in the chat can नहीं होता नहीं होता. Anyone in the chat can find the error in this
one. I got it. I found it. You forgot to answer the elements.
Yeah, नहीं we have to insert the element in the prefix, right? We are
exactly.
We are not updating our prefix. Yeah, in prefix we are just putting the
first value element only,
and after that we are first element. So we have to update our insert prefix set also, right? As we move from left to right, we just have to update it. Yeah. Now it is giving correct answer.
Now it's
so let's try to submit it.
Okay. This will give wrong answer, I guess. This will give wrong answer.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Anyone have idea?
Yeah. Let's see. It is a very frequent problem if anyone wants to guess.
Yeah, this is I also get it now. I know many, like in the beginning time we cannot explain how many times this error came, and now only we are making these silly errors. We shouldn't be making these errors.
So the problem
is I think
the constraints are the order 1 and
5. Yeah.
And we are storing product of three numbers, so that will be up to 1e15. So we should use long to store the product.
Yeah, so when I am doing this, yeah, जब मैं multiply कर रहा हूँ इन तीन values को, तो ये भी 15 हो सकती है, this can also be equal to 15, this can also be, so the product can be like up to 15, and integer can only store 19, up to 19, around 29. So this will give integer overflow, and that's why there is the wrong answer. So what I can do is, I have to like
answer. Data type of answer will be long.
And here I just have one LL will work, right?
Yeah, one LL will work. Yeah, now it should be
easy. Is it fine?
Did you submit?
Let's try to look at now.
Hello.
Hello.
So he's having some issues, I guess. Are you having some
issues? Let's hope the Elena. Oh. Now is it fine? I think.
Yeah, it's better now.
Oh my god, it is time limit exceeded, 2.52 seconds.
Okay,
let's try to optimize small thing. We can. I think it depends on servers sometimes, when there are like very tight constraints. Like as my network.
These are tight constraints. Like. 2e8 within 2.7.
Yeah, now its execution time is 1.7 second. Like there was like a server difference also. Okay. Sometimes it is accepted because solution is fine. I think we cannot optimize it further.
Yeah.
So guys, this
and log in contest, test, we can do this problem.
Yeah, and log in is the best solution we can come up to. Now any option like. Any of the problem, we can take it. Any doubt regarding this contest or anything else other than this, all the doubts are welcome. Yeah, Venkat Sri Harsh was commenting some kind of increasing triple subset sequence, but looping until end rather than first occurrence. I think that was fine.
So that was really good, right? It was really great experience, like watching you people submitting, sharing those thought process, right? And like the things that you discuss, jo mereko sabse acha laga na, that was part ki the wrong answer kyun aa raha hai, theek hai? So it will actually help our audience, right? If it will be helpful for them, and they should be learning from these things. Like these are small things, but they matters, right?
They
you
make a lot of
figure out like, why you are getting those. Exactly. So Anil,
yes, Piyush.
I just have one question for you, right?
Yeah. Hello.
Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, yes, Piyush.
Yeah, Anil, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, Piyush.
Okay. I just want to know, like, I'm curious to know that your point of view, like, do you enjoy coding in team, or like it would be better if you would be doing it individually? I want your perception, I want your views on it.
Both of them are great, like, but there are differences within a team and a solo. Like, if you are practicing solo, as Pawan have already said live here, that you can miss out on some silly errors, and like maybe you are really close to the logic but you are failing to achieve it. So being in a team helps you in that case. You can easily solve a problem which is maybe a bit above your level. Team helps you to achieve better goals. So if you are practicing, you should always practice in a team, and if it's a rated contest, like then definitely you should pass it according to the rules.
Okay, so Pawan, I have one question for you. It like this is very right thing from Anil, right? When certain generally what happens is when we are stuck at our code, right, we are not able to figure out that what is going wrong. When someone else look at the code and he can tell you that it was very easy thing that I was missing, and I was trying, like I have spent a lot last half an hour or an hour, and I was not able to figure out a single thing, right? It's a very small thing, but someone else looking at the code is easily able to figure out. So yes, I agree with you, Anil. I agree with you. So Pawan, my question to you is like, kabhi aisa hua hai kya ki jo aapne you have participated in a contest or you are not able to solve questions, right? मतलब पहला question हमने देखा, कोशिश किया, but the question was not submitted. We are getting panicked, right? तो उस state को कैसे handle करते हो आप लोग? किस तरीके से संभालते हो कि यार क्वेश्चन सॉल्व ही नहीं हुआ, पहला क्वेश्चन ही सॉल्व नहीं हुआ? तो होता है ना कि यार पहली बॉल देखा और वो इतना इतना टफ बॉल आया है, तो नेक्स्ट बॉल कैसे प्ले करना है, तो कैसे संभालते हो?
दिस हैपेंस लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स, लाइक वी लॉस्ट आउट अबाउट हाउ मेनी टाइम्स वी हैव वन, लाइक जनरल टेक्निक अबाउट दैट, लाइक मेनी टाइम्स इन द कॉन्टेस्ट व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग वी स्टक एट मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम वी स्टक एट द फर्स्ट और सेकंड प्रॉब्लम वी सॉ द लीडर बोर्ड दैट एवरीवन एल्स हैज डन इट नाउ वी आर मोर डिप्रेस्ड नाउ देन वी लुक एट ईच अदर एंड वी से पीछे से शुरू करते हैं लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बिहाइंड लाइक फ्रॉम द लास्ट क्वेश्चन एंड
ये तो
मेनी टाइम्स लाइक
ये बिल्कुल प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन पेपर में भी वैसे ही करते हैं भाई पहले जब पेपर मिलता है और आप पढ़ा दो क्वेश्चन नहीं हो तो अच्छे से स्टार्ट करते हैं यार ठीक है लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द
एंड वी डू दैट एंड फ्रॉम द लाइक फ्रॉम द बैक मेनी टाइम्स इट हैपेंस लाइक इट इज लकी और समथिंग लाइक द क्वेश्चन स्टार्ट टू हैपन एंड दीज लाइक एवरीवन स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द लाइक फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सो व्हेन वी सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन व्हिच नो वन हैज लाइक डन देन There is a pressure on others too, like they are doing that, like it must be tough question because it is at the like bottom. So that is also the case. So these are the like
This trick is going to work, right? मतलब ये examination में तो help किया है इसने हमेशा. अच्छा एक और चीज ना I would like that our audience must want like might be wanted to know. He you know that you knew that there are going to be three questions in the contest, right? अभी मैंने पहले क्वेश्चन तो क्या कुछ प्लानिंग करते हैं हम लोग क्या कुछ डिसाइड करते हैं कि हम पहले क्वेश्चन को कितना टाइम देने वाले हैं सपोज मैंने सोचा कि तीन क्वेश्चंस हैं 20-20 मिनट्स मैंने रिजर्व रखा तीनों क्वेश्चंस के लिए राइट एज अ टीम मैंने पार्टिसिपेट किया अब पहला क्वेश्चन मैं सॉल्व कर रहा हूँ एंड आई एम नॉट एबल टू डू इट एट 25 मिनट्स हो चुका है 30 मिनट्स हो चुका है पहला क्वेश्चन अभी मैं क्रैक ही नहीं कर पाया सबमिट नहीं कर पाया तो कैसे मैनेज करते क्या हम ऐसा कुछ प्लान करते हैं और अगर वो expectations nahi meet kar pati hain to fir kaise handle karta hu us cheez
yeah so it is
when we participate
carry on Anil
so I'll say when we participate in teams the general strategy is we begin either from the first question or from the last question and if you are stuck at a question for too long we skip that question and move to another question but like let's
like
say
how you define what is too long right like what is too long for you
like there is no like hard and rigid bound for too long but let's say neither of us is having an idea about the solution none of us can think a optimizable code so and like
yeah,
sometimes it happens that both yeah so sometimes it happens
yeah,
so that both of the members of the team are having different point of view on the solution like one of us thinks that it is possible to like optimize this code to a better solution and we can get AC and another one thinks that no it's impossible so then we start working on different questions
yeah
okay so Pawan you are saying something right in this context
yeah I was just saying this thing like there are like 2-3 types of stuck in position first is like we read the question and we like at the moment instantly we like recall that we cannot do this question like it is too tough for us then we skip immediately
out of syllabus
another
out of syllabus
yeah exactly another thing is we just read the problem and we like for first 5 minutes we try to like come up with an solution not the whole code just a solution we can see that if we can think of a solution in that case if we take like more than 5 or 6 minutes we will skip and another one is like it is like too bad when we code the whole thing and after that we like after yeah. that the, when the output is wrong and then we realize that it is not the optimal solution that we came up with then it is very bad like we spend whole the time we wrote the code and after that we are realizing that it is wrong. So these are the
skipping is better, right? Because you save time, you know that we can move to next question. But when you spend like 20-25 minutes on one question, after that you have to do it, right? Still you are not getting up with the correct answer. You have an approach in your mind, you have replicated it, you have coded it. Now you don't have any idea, right? But you have to do it because you have spent certain amount of time on it. Am I right?
Yeah,
that definitely it's a pressure. You have already spent 25 minutes on the question.
Yes, exactly, Anil. Exactly. I totally agree. और ये होता ही है एग्जाम्स में भी. अगर हम देखें मैथमेटिकल एग्जाम्स में ये होता है जब LHS RHS नहीं मिल पा रहा है, मतलब वी हैव सॉल्वड एवरी प्रॉब्लम राइट और LHS RHS नहीं आया, देन इट बिकम्स अ प्रॉब्लम. यार मैंने तो सोचा था हो जाएगा, ये वाला तो आता था, लेकिन ये हुआ क्यों नहीं? ठीक है, मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम्स में ऐसा ज्यादातर होता है. ओके राइट, मैं बोलूं तो बहुत मजा आया यार आप लोगों को देखकर, कोड करते हुए काफी कुछ सीखने को मिला. मतलब कुछ चीजें मैं ही मिस कर रहा था तो मेरे को भी सीखने को मिला. आई होप ऑडियंस को भी मजा आया होगा और काफी हम एक्सटेंड कर चुके हैं टाइम को. तो अभी क्योंकि कोई क्वेरीज आई नहीं है लोगों की तरफ से, तो शायद वो जब आप कोड कर रहे थे आपने उसी टाइम पर एक्सप्लेन कर रहे थे, तो आई होप दे वर एबल टू गेट द आइडिया ऑफ द सॉल्यूशंस दैट यू आर कोडिंग एक्चुअली राइट. बट स्टिल इफ एनीवन हैव सर्टेन डाउट्स यू कैन पुट देम इन द कमेंट बॉक्स एंड आई प्रॉमिस यू दैट वी और पवन एंड अनिल हिमसेल्फ विल बी रिप्लाइंग टू योर कमेंट्स राइट. We'll try our best to help you to understand the things, right? And also we are running, like we have already run out of our time. So I'll say like Pawan, Anil, I want to know your feedbacks on this. Like, are you liking the contest that we are conducting?
Definitely.
I'm really enjoying the contest. Like the problems are really good and they're like a mixture of medium to hard problems, so really fun to solve.
Okay, so how much you will rate today's contest, right? On a scale of 1 to 10, how much you are going to rate today's contest?
On difficulty level, right?
Yes, on the basis of difficulty level.
Okay, so first problem was, I think,
hardest or the easiest, like
10 is hardest.
Okay, Anil, let me talk to Anil, right? Anil, overall rating for the today's contest, difficulty level for today's contest.
So if 10 is the hardest, then I think 7 or 8 on is like, not like, yeah, 6, 7 or 8, like something like that.
6, not 7 a or really 8 hard contest, a range,
but the time limit was really hard on the last question, but varna to it was a bit easier.
Are aapne Pawan ke liye chhoda nahi na kuch, aapne ek range hi de diya, 6, 7, 8, right? Ek figure I want exact.
I'll say 7.5.
Okay, that's good. Pawan, your views on it.
Yeah, so the all over rating range is like, I will agree to Anil, but let me break up, like I will give the rating ranges of the individual questions. Yeah, so the first question was pretty easy, like it was just noticing things. So it was, I will guess, I think it will be 4 or 5 on the scale, okay. Difficulty scale. Second question was dynamic programming. Like for me, it was like standard dynamic programming. I have solved many problems, so I will rate it as like around 7. And the last problem was because of the time limit, because the solution and all was like logic was also a bit tough. And because of the time limit, I will rate it around 8.5. So these are the like difficulties for me.
Okay, so main aapko bata do, like everyone, let me jo bhi ye session dekh rahe. मैं बता देता हूँ कि इन्होंने जो रेटिंग की है ना, अनिल पवन ने, ये अपने स्केल पे की है. इनका 1 और 10 का स्केल है, राइट? आपको अगर रेट करना है तो अपने स्केल पे हिसाब से मैप करना पड़ेगा इस रेटिंग्स को, ठीक है? मतलब मैं अगर बोलूं तो मेरे को तो ये 7 से ऊपर ही लगेगा, 8, 7, 8, 7, 8, राइट? बट यस, सो डोंट बिलीव, डोंट ट्रस्ट ऑन देम. अपने स्केल को भी चेक करना आपके लिए 1 क्या है और 10 डिफिकल्टी लेवल क्या है, उसी हिसाब से ट्रस्ट करना है. सो इट वॉज नाइस, लाइक मैं यही बोलना चाहूंगा कि इट वॉज रियली नाइस सीइंग बोथ ऑफ यू कोडिंग टुगेदर एंड वी होप दैट वी विल बी हैविंग मोर सेशंस ऑन दिस. एंड एट लास्ट आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू लाइक आई वुड लाइक टू टेल एवरीवन, जो सेशंस हम स्टार्ट करने वाले थे बिकॉज ऑफ सर्टेन ट्रांजिशंस दैट आर गोइंग थ्रू, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू, वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग आवर सेशंस फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट मंडे विद पवन एंड अनिल. यू विल बी एबल टू एंजॉय द ग्राफ सेशंस एंड द डीपी सेशंस विद अनिल. यू द सेशंस आर देयर, बट थोड़ा सा जो डिले हो रहा है वो कुछ टेक्निकल अनअवॉइडेबल प्रॉब्लम्स हैं जिसकी वजह से हो रहा है, राइट? but you will soon see both of them sharing their ideas and knowledge with you all. And that's all for today. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Marat. Thank you very much. Thank you, Pavan. Thank you, Anil. It was really nice watching you.
Yeah.